What's happening, folks? Welcome to another episode of Ajax. Don't forget down below, if you're enjoying the series, hit the like button and all that stuff, and support the channel, and also links to Discord and everything down below as well, and second channel and Twitch and all that stuff as well. So today we're just showing the Leon game, the first leg only. Reason being is it's sheer scheduling. It's simply as the fact that this is my last day to record, and on Sunday I'm watching United game in the afternoon, and then I'm streaming in the afternoon as well. So, I need to get an episode recorded just to make sure. I want to keep it daily as much as I can, and it's this bit option. So yeah, Leon today. So we've got some transfer news, but I'm not going to show the player because, well, you'll see why in a second. Let's go through the games. Beat Vitesse Arnhem 4-1, and look at the guy who scored the goal on his debut. He scored Sebastiano Esposito, 4-1 victory, 4 goals on his debut. He's going to be the Haaland replacement, or so I thought. I'll get into why I'm saying I thought in a second. But yeah, 4-1 victory, he was absolutely phenomenal. Signed him for 27.5 million. Didn't pay that all up front though. It's like 7.5 million pound, a bit more across, like, I think it's 7.5 up front, 20 over whatever. They wanted 30 odd million for him, but I had to negotiate, and you know, it took a while to get it done. But yeah, I think he's a really good player for us. He's not asked for any release clause. He's not asked for us to be used as a stepping stone. So yeah, what a sign he could be. Then beat Spat Rotterdam 4-0. Doku with one, Haaland with a penalty, and 2 goals from Thiago Almeida. We were too good for him today. The good news is I can now rotate strikers more. And Haaland was an issue at the minute. He's not scoring many goals more than player at this point. I was very worried about him. But he got a penalty though in this game, so he's not to goal in. It was basically the goal that sealed the win, really, basically. It was 0-0, 2-0. I think we'll get 2-0 up in the games. I think we're pretty confident now we're gonna win. Previously I was always nervous about conceding one goal and getting nervous, but that seems to not happen as much. Fun nature of Pat Rotterdam in the league. Box standards, really. We then beat Excelsior 2-0. The first of two games back to back against them in both league, and obviously this one's in the cup. Hakim Ziyech and Sebastiano Esposito with the goals in this game early on in the match. We were completely in control of it, really. It wasn't the most exciting game overall, but we were in control of it, really. We just didn't create many clear opportunities after that, really, that I can remember. But 2-0 victory, you know, once again, 2-0 victory, another clean sheet. We then played him in the league and we won 4-0. Made obviously changes to his team as well. Van der Beek got one, Darren Ayers got two, and then Haaland got 2 goals as well. One from set piece header, second from open play. It was nice to see finally open play goal from him, because I noticed that his goals were penalties or free kick, as it was in this game. So nice to get an open play goal, 4-0 victory there. Good result. So after all the speculation, after all those transfer requests, he signed a new deal. I signed Esposito, so I had my insurance. I got Brown on loans. That's also my second insurance. And I thought, you know what? I'll offer him a new contract. Thinking it'd be a usual response, saying no. He signed a new contract, folks. So I'm surprised. Ideally, he could stay long term, but I've at least got my backup striker now. It's not as pressing if he decides to leave as it was before, because previously, if he left, I had no idea who to play up front. But now I've got Esposito up front, I can play him up front, so I've got someone to rotate him with. But yeah, I don't think this last of the saga, though. I'm pretty sure in the summer we might see some interest in him. But the fact the new contract's being signed is going to help us, hopefully. As you can see here, we're currently top of the table by a good margin. Obviously, PSV got game in hand over us. But I think we're going to win the league this year. I think not even I can mess this one up. If we compete, we could have an unbeaten season, but I don't think we will. I think at some point we'll come across like, not say play bad in the game, but get unlucky. You know, those games where you just, it won't go back in the net, and they get one goal from a set piece or a breakaway, which will happen at some point, I'm sure. But, you know, 20 games won out of 24, it's pretty damn good, isn't it? So the feature list looks like this, and the good news is, I can get a lot of episodes recorded today before I go away for the evening and then streaming and work. So today we're going to do Leon at home away on its own. Then we're going to come back, I think, for Leon at home and PSV at home, I think. And that could that PSV game could win it, could secure the title realistically for us if we win that game. Not nothing is official, but it'd be pretty close. And then we'll do the semi-final against Vitesse and a semi-final on its own as well. Now, if we lose this game like 3 or 4 nil today, I might just do PSV in the game on its own. I'll just see what happens in the game today. So let's go. Just yeah, I want to be there. I can make it there, but I've just got to record a bit en masse. So we've got no Bailly, no Cuadrado, and no Promes. Injuries, but not too bad. The back soon. So Darinez on the right wing. We've got Doku on the left. We've got Pihand up front. I can't switch his round. Yeah, that's better for Martinez, isn't it, at least. And Dest is suspended. I think there's one more person out in this game. And we're not going to play this formation. We're going to play this one because it's more defensively solid in my opinion. So let's go, boys. Let's see how we get on. Hopefully, I know those three subs are out of the range of the bench. So yeah, we'll go with that one. Assertive. We're huge underdogs. Yeah, I won't say we're huge underdogs. I wouldn't make us favourites, but I wouldn't say we're underdogs either. I wouldn't say we're massive underdogs. They've got Asensio. Okay. I mean, they probably are the better team. But we'll see how we get on, folks. And is a chance to get a shot on goal maybe here, long range from them. Tatim is spaced down the sides. Oh, God. Oh, thank God he's offside. I thought he'd give the penalty away. Tonali. Van der Beek. Akinjajic. Get right to Neves. Come on now. Beat you, man. Haaland in the penalty area. First chance of the game for us for Erling Haaland. On target, at least. That's all I expect from that. Ball in the box. Haaland! We've got an away goal already. Two big chances there. When the woman and the guy went to fall to it, it's him, isn't it? Martinez. Doku. Beats his man. Gets on the left-hand side. Can't find a ball in the box. He can't hold Erling Haaland! Looking lively today. I think definitely looking lively, Erling Haaland. Van der Beek. Get to the full-back. It's poor. This is breaking down a bit, isn't it? Oh, Douglas Foden goal! Scores! I thought it was going to break down a little bit there. Away goal, Doku has scored it. And since the early few minutes of the game, we've looked more likely to score a goal. I wouldn't say we've been like the better team, but we've looked like we had more of a goal in us in the last 5 minutes or so. Good ball by Tonali. Doku hits it back to Van der Beek. Nice little 1-2 there. Give and go. Gets in the penalty area, and it's a good finish. And it's an away goal in France. This is good. This is very, very good for us. Away goal. Yes, boys. Rafinha's going to take it. Kills it in far post. Cleared. Asensio. Sign that in. Just to concentrate a little bit, but 1-0 up, away goal. That's the minimum I wanted from this game. There he is. He's not great on the right-hand side. I remember that from before when I played been there for the Wolves let's play. He wasn't great on the right-hand side. That line. Oh, what a ball that is. Didn't think that was on. Haaland. David Neres. Cuts inside. Doku. You know what? If we get a second away goal here, I feel the tie could be really in our grasp. I think we've got a goal in us. Another goal in us. But I think they've got a goal in us as well. I think they're looking like every time they go forward, they're going to score. But they keep hitting shots wide, though. Oh, it's poor from Haaland, that. And, you know, there wasn't really any support that wasn't really for him, to be fair. Akinjajic. David Neres. Tonali. Good ball. David Neres. Just doesn't have the same effect on the right-hand side, does he? I like how we're just trying to play the ball from back. We need to just get the ball forward a bit quicker than this, because the outside presses. Get it out of here, lads. You're going to lose this ball if you don't get out of here. There we go. Again, poor pass. Sancho's in on goal. I don't know, man. The passes over the top are not there at the minute. The press is really good from Leon, though. Ball in the box. Get it clear. Well, here we go. Whack it clear. Haaland, hold on to it, bro. Half time, and there's definitely a case to say Leon have been unfortunate. If it was me, I'd be very annoyed with my team. I'd be very frustrated that we haven't got a goal if I was Leon. But we've gotten the away goal. It's the most important thing. It's very important we've got that away goal. So I'm going to say assertive. Got a guy against Quincy. The only thing I'm having problems with is the passing out from the back is a bit iffy. We're getting these areas here, and the ball's over the top are a bit short, and we just take too long to get the ball forward. But we are looking good defensively, sort of. If we can get, we've had a chance to get a second away goal, which has been a bit annoying. We haven't scored it yet, but if we get one of victory or 1-1 draw, even a 2-1 defeat, it's an away goal in Europe, and it gives us a good chance in the second leg. But I still think there's a second goal in this here. I do think we can score again. See that? I don't want to take too many touches in that area. It stresses me out. Doku, well done. Saik, Nivis! Just get that second goal, boys. Come on. If we get a second goal, I'll be in dreamland right now. I can shout with a freak long range. Goes for it. Off the bar. Can we give me a big break? Come on. I thought that was in. I thought when he curled, I thought he's got the whip on this. Keeper's not going to get it. And I thought he'd scored. David Neves. Tonali. Get in the box. Akinjaik. Tonali. Akinjaik. David Neves. Oh, yes, boys. I did say he's not great on the right-hand side, but he scored an absolutely fantastic goal today. And it might be a massive goal in this tie. Tonali, lovely, patient football. I mean, a bit fortunate maybe he didn't get the ball taken off him there because I thought they were going to go closing down. But again, down that inside channel, first time shot near post. Two away goals now in Lyon. It's a bit harsh on Lyon, I think. And they definitely look like more likely to score overall. But I thought we had a second goal in this. So I'm going to make some changes now because I'm going to take Van der Beek off and get Partey on because, you know, he might score a long-range shot again. And I want to take Doku off. And I'm going to play Almeida there. He's not ideal out there. But it's just fitness issues, you know. And I think there was some later on. But 2-0 in Lyon, folks. What a result this could be. One second, I think. Well done. Wait, ball. Haaland's in. Is this 3-0? I mean, it's not so much that he should score, but I expected a goal there for me he's been in this season. Tonali. Partey. You know what I'm thinking there, don't you, lads? David Neves, Akem Jaik, and Neves gets crossed. But yeah, 2-0 victory in Lyon, I think. I'll be delighted with that. Going to make one more change. I'm going to bring on Esposito for David Neves. Just again, for sheer fitness reasons. Just make sure that he doesn't get an injury. Now, can we keep a clean sheet? I've got a sticky feeling they're going to get one. Not with shots like that, they're not. Maybe they're not going to get one. 2-0 victory in Lyon, is it going to be? I'm not wasting time, so we're freaky, but we're still pleased. It's been a minute extra already. There we go. What a result that is. I mean, even game, you could argue, on stats. But a fantastic result for us. People written us off. This formation definitely works in Europe. I should have done it more in Europe before in the group stage. But a 2-0 victory over Lyon has given us a massive chance to get through to the next round of the Europa League. I don't think we've won a single knockout competition yet. Game in Europe yet, have we? I mean, we can check out last season as well. Let's check on that. Obviously, well, technically we did win that, but that was the playoff Champions League, because I don't really count that. So we didn't get out of the group there. No, that's the first knockout game we've won. Not won a tie yet either. So hopefully we can, you know, finish the job off and get it done. So next episode, like I said, we're going to do the Herenveen game off camera. Going to come back for Lyon and PSV at home. And then after that will be the semi-final. So yeah, hopefully you guys enjoy that. And until next time, thank you so much for watching. If you've enjoyed this video, and I hope you have, hit the like button down below. But until next time, thank you so much for watching. Bye-bye.